Hello, this week in this video I'm going to take you through setting up a Laravel homestead with a background, and in this entire 25 minutes video you are going to learn about how to set up it in Mac and with a step-by-step installation process. Let's get into setting up VirtualBox, background and homestead in a Mac. Here I'm on this documentation page, Laravel documentation for homestead. First of all, we need to install background. For that we need virtual machines. Here I'm going to install VirtualBox and Vagrant. After that I'll clone the Laravel Homestead Git project, and I'm opening these links for VirtualBox and Vagrant. I'll download Mac OS versions, and based on your operating system you can download OS X OS. I'm downloading this VirtualBox. After downloading I'll install this VirtualBox and Vagrant. Here for Vagrant should choose Mac OS. It will take a couple of seconds to download this. After that I'll install these two, VirtualBox and Vagrant. Then I'll proceed with the setting up our Laravel homestead. And I'm installing this VirtualBox. Downloading. We should proceed with the installation setup as per the operating system. It's verifying this VirtualBox package file. Okay. Here we should proceed with the installation process, and it's asking for the password. Install software. It's installing. And this VirtualBox is installed. Next I'll proceed with the Vagrant. I'm closing this VirtualBox and I'll eject this, unmount this VirtualBox. I have downloaded a wrong version. Previously I have clicked on a Linux version. I should download a macOS version of this Vagrant for installing in macOS. It's downloading. It's around 32 MB. It's downloaded. I'm clicking on it. It's opening this file. Here is a Vagrant package. I'm proceeding with the installation process, and it's asking for the password to install the software, and it's writing files. It will take a couple of seconds to install this application. After that, I'll go to the documentation page. It's installed, and I am ejecting this Vagrant, unmounting this Vagrant file. We'll go to the documentation and we'll proceed with the commands from the documentation page. Vagrant box add Laravel homestead to our that's a command we should enter through terminal for adding a homestead. We have a VirtualBox and Vagrant. This is a command to download this homestead setup. And here these are the three providers that supports. And here I am choosing this VirtualBox because I have installed VirtualBox. That's a second option. And it will take couple of minutes based on your internet speed. Here it's downloading. Successfully downloaded after couple of minutes. Next I'm going to proceed with creating a new directory. Inside a user directory, here I'll create a new folder with the name of Laravel. I'll use this directory to clone the Git project, Git homestead project. I'm checking the Vagrant version, Vagrant-V. It's a Vagrant 2.1.2 and a Laravel 5.6 version. I'm changing the directory to Laravel. It should be in root directory. It should be in root level. If I do ls, I should see this Laravel. Here is the Laravel directory. I'll use cd command, change directory, Laravel. Here I am going to do the git clone command. After this step, I have to install Homestead, installing Homestead step. For that, should use git clone and Homestead. For using this git clone command, I have to set up git, or else it will ask for developer tools, installation of developer tools. I am clicking on install. It will take a couple of minutes based on the internet speed. I am proceeding with this install because git is not installed on this machine. If you have already installed, you can proceed directly. I am clicking on install. It's asking for agreement, license agreement. It may take a couple of minutes for downloading and installing. After that, it should clone the project. Here it's cloning after installation. It's done. Here in this video, we did three steps. One is installing VirtualBox and Vagrant. Next, adding Homestead box and cloning this Homestead from Git repository. Here is a Homestead directory. I'll set up Laravel Homestead. Here we should execute this init.bat file from terminal. For that, I'll go to Homestead directory. And we can use Laravel for project and Homestead is for Homestead files. I'm going to this Homestead directory. I'm going to root directory, then Homestead ls. You can see all these files, init.sh. I should init this file. I should run this file, the bash init.php. It's already in the documentation page. Here this Homestead is initialized. You can see the message and you can see the changes in background files. I should see the configuration file, homestead.aml file. Here if I go through this documentation, here you can see the command, homestead.aml file and bash init.sh. In Mac or Linux and for Windows, it's a different command. Here I'm going to open this file in a Sublime text editor. And we'll create the projects in Laravel directory. Here I'm on Homestead directory. These are the files, list of files in Homestead and homestead.aml. It's a configuration file. I'll open this file and we'll go through it. Okay, this is the homestead.aml file. And we can add the folder structure, folders and sites here for our applications, for our Laravel applications. Here I am going to generate a SSH key for accessing Homestead box. SSH key, -t, RSA, and I am using email ID for generating public and private RSA key pair. Okay. I'm going with the default location and it's a blank. I'm using empty passphrase. It's generated. Here I have created a Laravel for Laravel application, for Laravel applications, and I am creating a basics directory for our Laravel basics course. In this basics directory, I am going to work throughout our course. Here I am creating a new file, index.php, and we'll link this basics directory in homestead.aml file, and we'll start the server so that we can see this. We should see this in a browser. We should see this basics and index.php file. Here I am echoing Laravel basics. That's a simple message. And we should map the folders, and we don't have a code folder. It's a Laravel. Under folders, map is Laravel. That's a Laravel directory. And here I am giving it as a code, home.vagrant.code. In our vagrant box, homestead box, and path is homestead test, and it's a reference path, home.home/vagrant/code. After that, it's a basics. It points to this Laravel basics, this path. Whenever I try to access homestead.test, it will access as this Laravel/basics. And I am making it as a Laravel basics, and we should add this to host file. I am going to do that. Sudo nano etc host. I am entering the password for accessing this file. Here in this file, I am going to add Laravel basics so that we can access this directory, basics directory, in Laravel, Laravel/basics. And we should start the server also, Vagrant machine. That's our homestead. 127.0.0.1 Laravel basics. I am going to save this file and will start the Vagrant server. That's our homestead box. It's a simple command for starting the server. It's a Vagrant up. It will take a couple of minutes for starting this server. And after that, we can access this Laravel.basics in a browser. So we should see the message that I entered in index.php in basics directory. It's starting the server, homestead box. Our Vagrant machine is up and running. Now if we load, I should see this message. Port 8000, 8000 and Laravel basics. If I update this text, I should see this updated message. It's updated. Next, we need to set up our Laravel application. We'll see it in the next video. I'm going to set up Laravel application. And in previous video, we have set up the RSA key pair, public and private key pair, so we can directly SSH to our Vagrant machine, Vagrant SSH. I'll be logged into this Vagrant machine. You can see I am already logged into this machine. Welcome to Ubuntu. All this message. And if I do ls, you can see the code. It's a reference point to our Laravel that we have set up in a homestead.yml file. And if we go to this code, you can see the basics directory. It's the same directory inside our Laravel application, Laravel directory. Here we need to use this command for installing will create some new files inside our Laravel, that's in code directory. It will take a couple of seconds to do these operations. It's downloading into vendors directory, and whenever we create a new application, these files will be used. And I'm creating a new application with this command, Laravel new basics. Basics is the application name and that's a directory name. It's already created basics, so we are getting application already exists. Here I'll create with a test so that we can test it. Laravel new test. Test will be the directory name and the project name. Creating application, crafting application, It will take a couple of seconds, and after completion we can see the message. Here you can see the test directory inside our Laravel directory. Here it's installing all these components and modules. It will take a couple of seconds. After that we should see message, application ready message. Application ready, build something amazing. Now we can use this test for loading it in a browser. Previously I have used a index file and echo message. Now we should see something different. For this to work, we should add a URL. We should add a configuration in homestead.yml file, and we should update this host file. And I am going to create it as Laravel test, and we'll be working on Laravel basics throughout this course. I'll set up the Laravel application for Laravel basics. For now, just for testing purposes, I am creating this Laravel test. I'm saving this file. We should start the Vagrant server, and we should configure it here in homestead.yml file. Here I'm copying this to map and to, and map will be Laravel test and to home Vagrant code, and it's a test. Instead of basics, it's a test. I'll use a Vagrant up command to start the server. We'll go to homestead. Vagrant up. Okay, it's already running. I'll try loading this, but it won't work. We should provision the server with the Vagrant provision. Laravel basics updated. It's loading the same file. I should use Vagrant provision. It takes a couple of seconds to provision the server, and now we can access this Laravel test. This should work. This time we should see Laravel application default page. For reload, 403 forbidden. You should remember this point. You should always add a public. Laravel application will serve from public directory. We won't be able to use the directory. This test directory. I have to add public. After the project directory, it's a public. Files from this public directory will be served to public. I am using Vagrant provision again. This will take a couple of seconds. It's done. If I reload, I should see this Laravel application, basic Laravel application. That's a default page. Here is a Laravel application default page. I'm going to set up a new Laravel application for basics directory. I'm going to delete the basics directory and will create a new Laravel application with this command, Laravel new basics. Here I am already logged into Vagrant mission with a Vagrant SSH command. This is a command to create a new application, Laravel new basics, and basics is a project name. Here I am deleting this directory. Now it should create. It's a crafting this application, and it will download all the dependencies. It's installing all the dependencies, and it will take a couple of seconds to set up this project, Laravel project. That's a Laravel application. It's almost done. And application ready. Here this is message after completion. I'm adding public directory for Laravel basics so that I can access this. And I am going to provision this server. For that we need to go to homestead directory. Then to run vagrant commands based on this file, it will execute. I am going to homestead directory from terminal. Here I am using vagrant provision command so that these changes will take place and we can access this application, that is laravel.basics. It's provisioning this server. It may take a couple of seconds. It's already done. If I update this path to Laravel basics, colon 8000, I should see Laravel application. It's the same Laravel application. And now we can work on this basics directory. I'll show you some of the commands, useful commands throughout our application. And one of the commands is vagrant up and vagrant provision. For starting the server, vagrant up, and for restarting it, it's a vagrant provision to provision the server, and a vagrant halt for stopping the server. And these are the project directories, test and basics in inside Laravel directory. It's provisioning the server. Now if we reload, it's working. We can stop the server with a vagrant halt command. And to access these vagrant commands, we should be in homestead directory. That's a main important point to note. And it's shutting down the VM virtual machine. If I reload the page, this won't work. The page Laravel basics and Laravel test won't work. It's a site can't be reached. That's correct. And I am using vagrant up command. To access this vagrant commands, we should be in homestead directory. And we can use PHP artisan. For that, we should be in application directory. To use PHP artisan, it's starting the server. It's started. If I reload the page, we should see the application in browser. I'll open a new window, new terminal window. I'll go to Laravel application, ls. Here I'm on this page, on this directory. I'm going to Laravel directory. Inside Laravel, I'll go to basics directory. Here I'm going to use PHP artisan tool. And these are the commands down for putting the application in maintenance mode. If I reload, I should see maintenance page, be right back. Application won't be available, only just this message. And to turn off the maintenance mode, PHP artisan up, application is now live. Here is the application. And these are the two commands, PHP artisan down and up. And the next command is cache clear for clearing the caches if there are any. Application cache cleared. And the next command is to create controller and create models. PHP artisan make. And there are a lot of commands for PHP artisan. These are the commands we'll be using in this course. Make controller and the controller name. I should use the controller name. With this controller name, controller will be created. PHP artisan make controller name, and PHP make model name. With this model name, model will be created in the application. In this Laravel application, that's a basics, because we are on basics directory. To use this PHP artisan tool, you should be in the application directory. Whatever the application you want to control, you should be in the directory. And for vagrant, you should be in homestead directory, and you can use vagrant SSH for accessing the machine, and we'll be logged into this machine. Here I'm on this machine, vagrant machine. You can see welcome to Ubuntu. And now we can run the commands, or we can create the application by going to this code directory, cd code Laravel new. That's a command for creating a new applications. After that, it's an application name. It depends on the name, whatever you want to use. It's a new application name. Laravel new is a command. After that, it's an application name. That's whatever you want to use for your application. And exit for exiting this vagrant machine. These are the useful commands, and I will be using these commands in this course. Congratulations, you just completed the setting up of Laravel Homestead with a VirtualBox, Vagrant. I hope you learned a lot in this video. If you want to learn more about Laravel, check out the next videos in this series. Thank you for watching, and do subscribe my channel.